Hey, what's up? Welcome back to Coil Labs, where now we have a whole new lab. Well, okay, it's the same lab, just with LEDs. Looks like we're on the bridge of the Starship Enterprise or something. Anyway, I guess I can't be in the High Voltage Cool Kids Club until I've jumped on the Slayer Exciter hype train now, can I? Seems like everybody and their grandma's built one of these at this point, and I'm late to the party. If you haven't seen a Slayer Exciter before, it's a really simple, low-power, high-voltage, high-frequency oscillator. Sounds a lot like a Tesla coil to me. But is it a Tesla coil? Well, like just about everything on the internet, this is a debated topic. Anyway, come back to that later. So, how do you build a Slayer Exciter? Well, here's the schematic and the list of components. I don't know, pause the video and take a screenshot or something. Go tattoo it on yourself, even. I swear to God, if somebody comes back and tells me they got a tattoo of the Slayer Exciter circuit... So, here's my circuit. Kinda helps if you have a transistor you could solder straight to the circuit board instead of one like this, but this is what I had, so f*** it. And I have it connected to this small Tesla coil secondary, and we're powering it with 9 volts from this power supply. You can even run these off of 9 volt batteries, but I couldn't find one, so we're just gonna use my big linear bench supply. That's right, kids. I have fancy professional tools, so I'm better than you. Also, pro tip, don't keep your smartwatch or your smartphone anywhere near high-voltage, high-frequency sources. The circuit isn't very powerful compared to a normal Tesla coil, but it can still produce really high voltages at high frequency from a pretty small input voltage. At least enough to light up these CFL bulbs and these low-pressure gas tubes. The way the circuit works is by sending pulses of current through the primary coil, which induces a large voltage in the secondary coil. Once current starts to flow through the secondary coil, however, it shuts the transistor off, which then stops the current flowing through the primary coil. Then, when the current in the secondary comes back down towards zero, the transistor turns back on, sends another pulse of current through the primary coil, and this on-off switching repeats at high frequency. The secondary coil on the top will form a resonant inductor capacitor, or LC circuit. And the natural frequency that this wants to resonate at determines the frequency that the transistor is switched on and off.
Can't run this for very long though, because this transistor gets real damn hot. Ooh, yeah, that's a little toasty. Now there are a lot of different versions of this circuit you can make. Some of them are more powerful using a MOSFET instead of a small NPN transistor. I was going to show you how one of those works, but after roasting this many MOSFETs and gate driver chips, I decided to do something sensible and stop committing war crimes against my transistor supply. Like, look at this gate driver. Absolutely cooked itself trying to spank this FET and make it switch fast enough. Worst smell ever, would not recommend, 0 out of 10. Part of the problem is I'm a dumbass and I don't have any formal background in power transistor switching theory. That said, I've got a reasonable gate resistor, input diode clamp, output diode clamp, zener diode for overvoltage protection, bypass capacitors, everything, and it still blew up. The other problem is, this kind of circuit is just overly simplistic and it's actually really hard on whatever transistor you put in there. You're forcing it to hard switch very large current pulses at high frequency, and guess what? Transistors really don't like that. If you care about not blowing up your components, try and switch them at as close as possible to the current zero crossing. That requires a lot more sophisticated circuitry though. So back to the question we had earlier, is a Slayer Exciter a Tesla coil? Some people say it's not for various reasons, but in my opinion, yes it is. It's just a specific type of single resonant solid-state Tesla coil that uses the current in the secondary itself as the feedback. It's a neat little circuit, but doesn't scale up very well. Speaking of single resonant solid-state Tesla coils and better circuits, however, I'm going to be doing a collaboration with a bunch of other Tesla coil YouTubers, including Lab Coats, the Plasma Prince, PowerMax, SciTubeHD, Archangel, and the Magnetizest. We're all going to be building our own versions of a solid-state Tesla coil around a common driver circuit design. So, keep an eye out for that coming soon. Thanks to Zach from Lab Coats for organizing this and for providing us with the driver circuit design. He even customized my circuit board and put my dumb face on it. And in case you didn't know, I'm on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook as well. You can follow me there if you want to stay up to date on what's going on in between videos. Because you all know how long it takes for me to upload new videos, apparently. What? have a job, and these projects take a lot of time. Anyway, Coilers, thanks for watching. Stay safe, don't electrocute yourself, and I'll see you all next time.